Welcome back to another edition of Glossika's World Kitchen. Today, we're going to make a classic Taiwanese treat, the delicious and famous boba milk tea. Yes, you can make it in the comfort of your own home, simple and easy with just a few ingredients. So let's get started. For this recipe, we'll be using just a few ingredients you can see laid out here. It's very important to use good tea leaves for this recipe. The quality of the tea really comes out and enhances the flavor. You can try making your own tapioca pearls from scratch, but I think the store-bought ones are just as good and are much easier for this recipe. We will start by first boiling our tapioca to make our boba. These will cook in water for about 20 to 25 minutes. Make sure you stir the pot once in a while to prevent the boba from sticking to the bottom. In Chinese, boba milk tea is 珍珠奶茶. 珍珠奶茶. 珍珠 actually means pearl. So in Chinese, we're actually calling these pearl milk tea. But if you say 珍珠, sometimes in Taiwan, it can actually refer to the smaller tapioca balls. While if you say boba, everyone knows you're talking about the bigger ones. You can tell your boba is cooked when there's no white parts left, and it's mostly a transparent black color. And when you taste it, it's chewy and not hard. We're going to strain our boba out and rinse it under cold water. This helps the boba not become too sticky, since it naturally already is. Next, we're going to melt some brown sugar in a pan on low heat. I think one cup here is good, but you can add more to taste. Brown sugar in Chinese is 黑糖. 黑糖. So brown sugar in Chinese is actually translated into black sugar because of the color. Make sure when you go to the store, you're buying unrefined brown sugar, as it is more flavorful and creates a thick coating around the boba. Once the sugar begins to melt, you can start pouring the boba into the pan and cook this slowly until it becomes melted and thick. Next, we'll steep some black tea. You can do this while the boba is cooking to save some time. You can adjust the amount to how strong you want your tea to be. Pour hot water and let it sit until the color of the water is dark red. Another word in Chinese that is a different color when translated is black tea. Black tea is actually called red tea in Chinese. 红茶. 红茶. Again, because of the color. I'm not sure what color your black tea is, but ours is red. Boba milk tea originated in the 80s in Taichung, Taiwan. Growing up, this was something we drank all the time. After your tea is done, you're ready to assemble. Take a spoon and scoop some of the brown sugar coated tapioca into a glass and gently stir it around to coat your brown sugar evenly inside. Now we'll put a few ice cubes in the glass as well. Ice cubes in Chinese is 冰块. 冰块. Next, fill the glass 2/3 with the black tea or 红茶. And lastly, we'll finish it with some fresh milk. You can always use milk powder, but I prefer real milk. Or if you want to use plant-based milk, oat milk is also really good for this recipe. Fresh milk is called 鲜奶. 鲜奶. And if you'd like oat milk, you can say 燕麦奶. 燕麦奶. And there you have it. Quick and easy boba milk tea from home. Let's review the new Chinese vocabulary we learned today. Boba milk tea. 珍珠奶茶. 珍珠奶茶. Pearl. 珍珠. 珍珠. Brown sugar. 黑糖. 黑糖. Black tea. 红茶. 红茶. Ice cubes. 冰块. 冰块. Fresh milk. 鲜奶. 鲜奶. Oat milk. 燕麦奶. 燕麦奶. Hope you liked our homemade boba milk tea recipe and got to learn some Chinese in a fun way. Let us know in a comment below if you tried this at home or if there are any other recipes you'd like to see us try. If you thought this was fun, please give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more language learning content. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!